guys, my name is Courtney. I'm with Crafty Corner, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to upload files to Cricut's Design Space. Have you ever been at a blog or you've been browsing through Pinterest and you keep seeing projects that someone's made with their Cricut and it says free SVG file or free cut file, and you're like, that's great, what does that actually mean? I'm gonna unpack that today. In a nutshell, what this means is that the person who has created this project has created the design file in a program outside of Design Space. Typically, people use programs like Adobe Illustrator or free programs online like canva.com. But basically what they've done is they've created the design file or the project file outside of Design Space. And so now this means that you can download that file and upload it to Design Space so that you can make it too. So in this video, we're gonna cover a few different things. First, we're gonna unpack what kind of files can you use in Design Space. And then the second thing we're gonna look at is how to upload a file. And we're gonna unpack that in two ways. I'm gonna show you how to upload a PNG file, which is an image file, and an SVG file, which is a vector file. And I personally think PNG and SVG are some of the most common files that you'll see that you can upload to Design Space. But as you'll see shortly, there are tons of different files that you can upload to Design Space. Okay, so to get started, I'm gonna flip the camera to my computer screen and I'll show you what kind of files that you can upload in Design Space. All right, so finding out what kind of files you can upload to Design Space is super simple. I clicked on New Project, so I'm just on the Canvas page here, and I'm just gonna click on Upload, which is where we'll go in a second. But as you can see, you can upload images and patterns, and for the sake of this video, we're just gonna focus on image. You don't really need to worry about pattern. So here are all the different kinds of images that you can download. So there's multiple different kinds, but like I mentioned earlier, I would say the most common that I see are PNG, and also you'll see a lot of SVG files. You just need to know when you're uploading images what ones you can upload, and two, if you do click on upload image and upload an image that isn't one of these kinds of files, it's not going to let you upload it. So just be aware, and like I said, most often you'll see PNG or SVG files. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how to upload files to Design Space. I'm going to be uploading a PNG file and an SVG file, and the reason I'm doing this is because they each upload a little bit differently, but what's important to know is that the process for uploading a file, whatever file type it is the same. But I just wanted to show you how a image file, like a PNG or a JPEG, would upload and how a vector file would upload, because there are just some helpful things to know. So the first one we're going to upload is a PNG file.
So the first step is going to be to save your PNG or your image file or whatever file to your computer. And then we'll come to Design Space and start a new project. And then if you come over to the left-hand column over here, we're going to click on Upload and then Upload Image. And then you can either drag and drop your file here, or you can click Browse and find your image. So as you can see, this is the image I'm going to be uploading today. As you can see, it says .png, so we know it's a PNG file. So I'm gonna click on it and click open. And now it's gonna ask me what type of image that it is. And you can I just kind of like to click through here and pick one that I think makes it look the best over here. Since mine is super simple, we can just leave it like that. But if you have like a really fancy photo or something you're trying to upload, you wanna do complex. But I'm gonna do simple and then hit continue. And now this new screen is going to let us edit the image. So I'm gonna zoom out here. Up here you can see the zoom out and zoom in the top left-hand corner. I'm just gonna zoom out, and as you can see it right now, we've got the black bunny and then it has a gray background. We need to remove the background from the bunny image, because if you come down here and click preview, when I upload it to Design Space, that's what it's going to upload as, just a giant box basically. So we need to get rid of the background around the bunny. So to do this, you can come up here on the top left hand corner, and there's a few different tools that you can use. So you can crop to get rid of most of the background, so we'll crop that, but then we still need to get rid of the gray. This erase tool is also really nice. You can just drag your cursor over and it will start to erase parts. So do you see how the background is now coming up as this like checkered pattern? That means it's going to be transparent. And we can increase the size of the cursor to make it bigger. And you could do this if you want, but it's gonna be really hard when you get around the bunny, because you'd have to literally trace around it. So one of my favorite tools when you're working with a super simple image like this bunny is this select and erase. And it's super smart because all you do is click on the area you want it to erase. I don't know how, but it just knows what to erase. So as you can tell, it took away most of the background. But then I'm gonna zoom in up here because as you can see, I've got a few gray pieces left from where I tried to erase it with the eraser tool. So I'm just gonna click on eraser again, and I'm just pushing down on my mouse and erasing. So now that looks pretty good. And you can either click continue and it will show you what it looks like. I'll go back here. Or you can click preview here. So you can tell there's still a lot up here that I need to clean up. So I'm gonna go back with my erase tool and erase those areas. And those are super tiny and hard to see. So if you need to keep zooming in, you can definitely do that. That's about everything. So I'm gonna click preview again. And so now you can see all of that is gone. So it looks pretty good. So now I'll hit continue. There are two different ways that you can save it, but we, for the sake of just cutting, we wanna save it as a cut image. We're not gonna worry about print then cut at the moment. We just want to save it as a cut image. You can give your image a name if you want, so you can search for it, add some tags, but when you're done, you'll just click save. And then it'll take you back to the first screen that we were on when we clicked upload over here. And now you can see our bunny made it in. So it is ready to go to the canvas. But before we get to the canvas, I wanted to show you. This is the screen when you are looking to retrieve your uploaded images. You'll come back here, and if you click view all, you can search through all of your uploaded images. So that's pretty nice. They're all stored. And that's why naming it something like bunny just makes it really easy to search through. So I'm gonna hit cancel. We'll go back to upload, and now I'm gonna click on the bunny and click insert images. And now it's inserted into Design Space. So that is a PNG file. I did want to say quick too, if you can find images like the bunny that come with a transparent background, then you don't need to do any of the image cleaning up. If you can find images with transparent background, that's perfect. Otherwise, you'll just have to clean up your image like we did. We just had to remove the background to get the bunny shape. So that is PNG files.
All right, so now we've uploaded a PNG file, and the last thing I want to show you is how to upload an SVG file. SVG is a vector file, which is just super fancy graphic design terms. You don't really need to like know all the ins and outs. It's not that big of a deal, but just know that the SVG will upload just a little bit differently than a PNG file. So I'm gonna flip back to my screen and I'll show you what I mean by that.
All right, so now we are going to upload an SVG file. And like I mentioned at the beginning of the video, uploading files, you'll follow the same steps every time, regardless of what file type it is. So we'll click upload, upload image, browse, and then we're going to upload the SVG. So as you can see here, it says you've got mail.svg. So we know it's an SVG file, so we're gonna click on that and click open. And when I click open, take note of how the screen is gonna become different than when I uploaded the SVG file. So as you can see, it didn't take you to edit the image. It didn't ask you if the image was complex or simple. It just took you straight here and told you to give it a name, and we're gonna hit save. So what's super nice about these SVG files is that they already come with a transparent background, and they're already basically like ready to go. So you don't need to clean up the image at all. You can just click save. And then same thing, click on your image and click insert images into Design Space. All right, before we wrap up here, I wanted to show you why SVG files are different. Because it's a vector file, but if you come over into this layers panel, you can see that even though everything is grouped together on the canvas, they're actually all individual files. So when we go to click make it, check out how it's going to cut it. It's kind of all like on its own, not what we want it to be. So what we're going to do is weld the image together so that it stays like this, because I want it to cut like this. I do not want it to cut the other way. I want it to just be one layer, one file, one image. So keep an eye on this layers panel over here. What we're going to do is click on the group. So you can either click on the You've Got Mail or click on it here in the canvas, and then come down here and we're gonna click weld. But before I do that, just keep your eye on this layers panel. So you can see here, these are all actually individual layers, which is why it cuts differently and not as one group. But when we click on the whole thing and click weld, check out what happens to the layers. There. So now it's literally just one image. It welded it all together. And so when you click on make it, It's perfect. So the reason I wanted to share that with you is because that is just unique to SVG files. It's cool though, because let's delete this and go back to upload, and we'll put this back on the canvas. If for whatever reason you wanted to come in and change image, you can do that. So let's say we wanted to get rid of you've and just, you know, for whatever reason, we just wanted to say got mail. You can manipulate the image and move the items around, which is pretty cool. So just remember that when you click weld, you can't unweld. So it's gonna stick everything together and it will be permanent, but you can always go back like I did and re-enter the SVG back onto the canvas.
All right, so that's all there is to it. Uploading files to Design Space is super simple, and I hope that you guys found this video helpful. If you have any additional questions about this or anything Cricut or Design Space related, drop a comment below and one of us on our team would love to help you out. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and hit subscribe for more Cricut videos. Thanks for watching.